Okay, so maybe you've never heard of this before, but Monday is actually Green Monday, and it's one of the last days for online deals before Christmas. I spoke with Mike Koyanen from Principal Preservation Services tonight about how to finish your shopping list while also keeping your finances in check. Thanks for joining us, Mike, on a Saturday night.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Okay, so I learned something new today because I learned that there's such a thing as Green Monday. So fill me in.
Yeah, it's gaining a lot more traction, of course, when people are shopping online. And it's actually the second largest online shopping day out there behind Cyber Monday. So with Cyber Monday and Black Friday gaining a lot of traction, the most sales ever online this year, Green Monday is going to probably fall right in line with that as well. And it happens 10 days prior to Christmas. So since 2007, it's gained a lot more traction.
Okay, yeah, when people are getting closer, those last minute shoppers are looking for stuff. Where are the good deals at?
Well, I think there's a lot of good deals out there right now. If you've been online, I think, and the numbers show that. But, you know, if you want to get that good deal, you actually have to be prepared before you do that, right? And so I will say set and stick to a spending plan. Because, you know, some people are easy to buy for, some people are not. People tend to buy things for themselves sometimes, and there's so many good deals. And you want to stick to that budget because you can just find yourself in trouble at the end when you end up buying for yourself or buying for somebody who's easy to shop for as opposed to those ones who are hard to shop for. So that could put your Christmas shopping in crisis mode if you actually don't stick to that budget. Kind of basic 101 of shopping, right?
Do you have a recommendation for how much people should budget for the holiday season, like a certain percentage of maybe their salary, or what's kind of the rule of thumb there?
Well, when it comes to that, it really comes down to where you are financially. And of course, 2020 has really changed a lot for everybody. So I think we find out in this year, health is more important than a lot of having things, right? And I think experiences sometimes are more than important than things. I think a lot of the clients who have come to my office, I want to spend their money on experiences with family rather than things. So as I look back in my time in history, we spend within our budget today. I think when we're younger, we tend to spend outside of our budget. And I think that's just a normal part of growing up and maturity.
Mm-hmm. You talk about doing research and really looking at the deals before this shopping holiday.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people are getting more experience with this and getting more comfortable being online. And I just think it's important to open up another web browser and just find that or put in a coupon code or promo code or even online they're doing price matching. I think it's interesting as you go to try to close out a browser, somehow that store knows you're going to close out that browser and they give you 15 to 25% off. So use these little tactics to your advantage to save some money. But just check around because a lot of people are giving good deals. Find that best one for you.
Yeah. And while you still have time to ship it, if you're shipping it to loved ones who are further away.
Yeah, exactly. And sometimes you have to watch those shipping days because they might not have it in stock in their warehouse, but they might have it in the store locally, so you can actually pick it up in store. So watch for those as well.
And a couple of things to watch out for: scams. We've mentioned it a lot lately, but that's because they're so prevalent right now, especially with all these people shopping online.
Yeah, with setting records online brings out the unjust, the people who want to take advantage of us as we are, you know, shopping online. So if you see these ads online, or maybe the social media, for some stores that you've probably not heard of, but these deals sound so good to be true, they probably are. So stay away from that. You even get phone calls from people calling you to get your personal information. They might pretend to be an Amazon or eBay representative. I actually had a client who fell for that about a year ago, and then he had to go through the identity theft process because he gave all his personal information over the phone. And when he hung up the phone, he knew it was a mistake right away in his gut. But stay away from that. Just be careful with stores that that you haven't heard of before. Make sure they're trusted site.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, be careful of others. And then also be careful of yourself and keep yourself responsible and keep an eye on your credit cards, you say.
Yeah, that's one of the biggest issues right now is people are, you know, the average household has almost $8,000 of credit card debt. And after the holidays, we know that number is going to raise up. And I'm not a big fan of using credit cards. When I was younger, I went through that issue. I've been credit card debt free for, I think this is going on 8 years now, with no credit card debt. So I've been there, I've done that. So I just tell people, credit cards is a convenience. It's not there to be a personal loan for you. If you can't pay that credit card off every month, it's not worth putting it on there. Because that deal you think you're getting, you're not getting a deal. You're going to pay more over time if you make payments. So don't charge things that you can't afford. That just comes out to budget. As you make more money over time, you can afford more. But credit cards are like a catalyst to other financial issues. And that's going to cause credit score issues, could cause higher insurance rates, could cause you delaying marriage, delaying getting in that house you want to get into. So just stay away from racking up credit card debt. Stick to your 2020 resolutions you made back 11 months ago, right?
Yeah, who remembers those? Those are out the window by now. All right.
Yeah,
I know. We'll have to leave it there. Thank you so much, Mike. Green Monday.
Yeah, thanks for having me, Aaron.